The president and CEO of the Greater Ottumwa Legacy Foundation, Brad Little, has accepted a new job in Fort Wayne, Indiana. He will be the president and CEO of the Community Foundation of Greater Fort Wayne. Little and his wife, Melissa, who is the executive director of the Ottumwa Area Convention and Visitors Bureau, are both from Indiana, and this job will take them back to a place much closer to family and friends. Over the last two Mondays in the conversation, we have looked at some of the history and some of the successes the Legacy Foundation has accomplished. Tonight, we asked Little if there was anything he was leaving undone that he wished could have been finished.
Well, the quiet zones, as the train blows in the background while you and I are chatting, is one that I had hoped to have done sooner. You know, it's been 4 years in the making, and that's a big one that's going to lead to more commerce, more residents downtown. It's one that the train whistles, as nostalgic and romantic as we want to make them, it really impedes folks wanting to live downtown and certain businesses not being able to be here. So that's one that I know it's going back out to bid, but that's a big one we looked at early. The riverfront, I wish we'd have made more progress on the riverfront, or at least on an initiative. We've got a great plan. And in fact, we've got a couple of folks that have asked, some employers that have asked for the plan, and we're making copies right now. And, you know, the theater. We've done some great work getting the theater presentable and respectable and programmed now with a concert in it, but I think that's another one that, boy, we could have done a little bit more with that. But I think all three of those are set up nicely to get across the finish line.
We also asked Little if there was anything he wanted to say as he finishes up his 7 years with the Legacy Foundation.
I think Ottumwa, as I said, is really on the verge of some really great things. But I think, folks, we're our own worst enemy. And we're not big enough to have a mass of naysayers. And so we need everyone supporting and encouraging, and even we're a diverse community that's becoming more diverse by the minute, and we need to embrace that diversity, and we also need to be supportive and more encouraging of new thoughts and new ideas as those folks to our community bring their experiences with them from wherever they've been.
Little will begin his new job on December 8th, but his wife Melissa and their children will remain in Ottumwa through at least the end of the school year.